And you know, the other thing is, I don't think our national security should be treated like another line item government welfare program. In other words, one of the responsibilities of the federal government is our national security, our defense. And I think too many people are being lured into this notion that, you know, everything is exactly the same when it comes to the federal budget, and it's not, is it?
No, it's not, Mark. You're absolutely right. And we've got, when you get into the national security arena, only the federal government can do that. That isn't something you can pass off to the states or local units of government. There are other functions of government that can be handled and performed by those other elements. But the number one priority, if you read the Constitution, the thing that's mentioned more than anything else, both with respect to the Article 1, talking about the powers and authority of the Congress, as well as the President's authority under Article 2, more than anything else, you get the importance of maintaining the military and safeguarding the nation. And it's absolutely essential that we not strip ourselves of that capability now. We're going to have to make some tough choices. There's no question what we've got to get a handle on spending. But we cannot willy-nilly do violence to our defense requirements and expect not to do serious damage to our long-term capabilities.
Well, Mr. Vice President, I know you have to go. Just want to repeat what an honor it is. You're welcome back anytime, and it is a terrific book in my time. Please give your wife my best. She's been on this program before, and be safe. Be healthy.
We'll do it. Thanks, Mark. Thanks for having me.
All right. God bless.
I am paying for this microphone, Mr. Speaker.